What's going on, my fellow rock and rollers? Now, we've all heard about rock stars behaving badly, but this is a story that flew under the radar. Pearl Jam's manager's assistant, Colleen Combs, would talk to author Mark Yarm about Eddie Vedder's struggles with fame in 1993 following the release of the band's album Verses. She would say, Pearl Jam was getting bigger and bigger. 10 was a hit quickly, and then Verse set the all-time highest first week sales record. It looked like things were never going to calm down. Eddie Vedder didn't go through the building process, the years it takes to get acclimatized to what's happening. It was all at once for him. Otherwise, he would have known he just couldn't go bar hopping with somebody on tour. Now, Pearl Jam was 2 weeks into their US tour in November of 1993 to promote their record Verses, which came out 1 month earlier. The band had stopped in New Orleans for 3 shows, and the night following the first show, Vedder found himself in the French Quarter at 4 in the morning, and he was joined by members of the supporting band named Urge Overkill, as well as Major League Baseball pitcher Jack McDowell of the Chicago White Sox. Now, Eddie and his friends were drinking at a bar in the city's French Quarter when they were approached by a local resident named James Gorman, who was a local waiter and an apparent music aficionado. According to Vedder, who told author Mark Yarm, I talked to this guy for a while and we tried to walk on, but this guy just wouldn't let it go. He still had to have more. He still had to cover some major points, and Blackie from supporting band Urge Overkill says, look man, just mellow out, we're going, you know. And this guy's going, no, 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 I just want to say one more thing. And finally, I just kind of held him up against the wall and spit in his face. Big effing deal. Anyways, all hell broke loose. Now, following Eddie's spitting in Gorman's face, a fist fight erupted and spilled into the street. It was alleged that Vedder knocked Gorman unconscious while McDowell was injured by bouncers from a nearby nightclub. Now, when the police showed up, Eddie was charged with public drunkenness and disturbing the peace. Now, Gorman, for his part, believed that he did nothing wrong and claimed that Vedder spit on him for no reason. And one of Eddie's friends who was there claimed that Eddie Rosser, who was a member of the opening band Urge Overkill, disputed Gorman's account and claimed he went up to Vedder and said, you're not so effing great, before Vedder spat on him. And Rosser would claim that once the police showed up, they told Eddie to shut up, otherwise they would arrest him. And of course he didn't comply, so the police hauled him off to jail. Now, Eric Johnson, who was Pearl Jam's tour manager at the time, would be tasked with bailing out the singer, and remembered that moment telling author Mark Yarm, I got to bail Eddie out of jail at 5 in the morning. By the time I got there, he'd already made friends with everybody. I remember the smell of alcohol when I got there. It almost burned my eyes. It was Eddie. He had been having a serious party. In 1994, a judge would acquit Eddie Vedder of a battery charge, and one of the witnesses who testified against the singer was the guy he spit on, James Gorman. But the New Orleans judge would rule, I didn't think they were believable, referring to the witnesses. And Gorman, for his part, would file a $3 million lawsuit against Vedder, but of course it went nowhere. So that concludes today's video, guys. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. And as always, if you have suggestions for future topics, let me know in the comment section below. If you guys want to support my channel, simply watch another video or go check us out on Patreon. Take care.